welcome to the Office 365 update for January of 2017. Before we get started with the news, I wanted to remind you that your feedback on this series is important to both myself and to the production team. We announced a pilot in October with the sole purpose of gathering input on how we could serve you better. While we receive some suggestions, we'd like to hear from more of you. Please visit the URL listed on the screen and share your thoughts. You can either post your own idea or vote on or comment on the ideas of others. Of course, you can always contact me directly at the email listed on the screen. And I'll make every effort to respond. Now, on to the updates. I introduce you to Quick Starter and Microsoft Sway in the November update. It's an intelligent service that lets you go from a blank canvas to a compelling working Sway outline in seconds. I'm pleased to announce that Quick Starter has been extended to PowerPoint. Simply click on the Quick Starter option in the new PowerPoint screen, enter your topic, and Quick Starter shows you a menu of potential slide templates. Select the slide templates you want in your presentation, choose the graphic theme from the array of options presented, and then click Create. Quick Starter builds a deck for you that includes key facts, related topics, and a table of contents, and a set of slides on the topic and design you chose. You'll still need to provide the details, but Quick Starter automatically and intelligently creates a starter PowerPoint presentation for you to work from. It lets you focus on the presentation content, handling the outline and design choices automatically. If you'd like to see Quick Starter in action and learn more about the intelligence behind it, watch the Microsoft Mechanics episode embedded in the November 29th blog post. While some old-timers, like yours truly, might fondly remember when VisiCalc and later Lotus 1-2-3 were kings of the spreadsheet world, Excel has been the preeminent spreadsheet for the better part of 30 years. It's been a cornerstone of Microsoft Office and an indispensable tool for crunching numbers and displaying that information visually. Over the last few years, Excel has released a powerful set of capabilities based on the Power Query technology, which provides fast, easy data gathering and shaping capabilities. These tools are accessed through the Get and Transform section on the Data Ribbon. On December 1st, the Excel team announced 10 new data transformation and connectivity features our customers have been asking for. If you're not familiar with Excel's Get and Transform features, a great place to start is on the Office Support site. I've included a link in the additional resources for this course. If you're already a Get and Transform Power user, be sure to check out the December 1st Office blog post for the latest improvements. Editor in Word 2016 is a new writing assistant that helps you create better documents by providing enhanced proofing and editing services. Leveraging machine learning and natural language processing, Editor provides context on why certain words or phrases in your documents might not be the best choice, hopefully improving your writing skills. For example, Editor detects writing that may be wordy or includes redundancies and suggests more concise language. It also enhances spell check by showing the definitions of the possible correct words by ensuring you're choosing the right one, especially when the words sound the same. I think my high school teacher called these homonyms, or was it homographs or homophones? I can't remember. If you're a little unsure about how the word should sound, you can choose Read Aloud from the shortcut menu to hear the proper pronunciation. Editor uses visual cues to distinguish between different types of suggested edits. Misspelled words are underlined with red squiggles, just like they always have been. Grammar cues are highlighted with a blue double underline. And the new writing style and word usage suggestions are flagged with a gold dotted line. That gold color choice must mean those suggestions are really valuable. Anyway, these new enhancements to Word help you improve your writing and ensure that your message comes across as intended. For additional information, watch the Microsoft Mechanics episode embedded in the November 29th blog post. You can also find additional information on support.office.com. One piece of feedback I get consistently is that you watch these videos and then look for the features I mentioned in your own copy of Office. Some of you don't see the feature and write back asking where it is. All the way at the bottom of Kirk Konigsbauer's November 29th Office blog post is a paragraph with resources that I hope will remove some of the mystery. Office 365 Home and Office 365 Personal customers will want to join the Office Insiders program to be the first to see the features I cover. The answer is a little longer for commercial customers, but is explained in the link provided in that paragraph I mentioned. So please be sure to give it a read. Office on Windows desktops has long supported the opening and editing of documents residing on a wide variety of third-party cloud storage providers. This is a result of our Cloud Storage Partner Program, or CSPP. It ensures customers can get work done in Microsoft Office wherever their documents are stored. Great news for our Android users. On December 1st, the Office team announced that the CSPP is now available for the Office apps on Android devices. It's easy to add a cloud storage provider from the Add a Place menu in the latest versions of Word, Excel, and PowerPoint on Android. Then you can edit and share your documents stored with that provider as easily as you can do with those stored on Microsoft's OneDrive or OneDrive for Business. You can also launch Word, Excel, or PowerPoint directly from the cloud storage provider's app to edit your files with changes automatically saved back to the cloud. The list of available cloud storage options in Office for Android includes Dropbox, Box, Ignite, and Tencent. The Office team is working on adding Citrix ShareFile, Edmodo, and Learnium as well. The list of options will continue to expand over time, and I'll be sure to keep you up to date on new developments. Microsoft's Visio, not to be confused with the Visio brand best known for its televisions, there's one of those pesky Hama-somethings again, has been a trusted tool in diagramming for more than a decade. Visio has helped thousands of organizations blueprint the business processes that drive the digital transformation. On December 8th, Microsoft announced two exciting updates, Visio Viewer for iPad and the Visio Online Preview. These two enhancements enable users to access Visio diagrams stored on OneDrive for Business or SharePoint from nearly anywhere. Visio Online Preview amplifies the power of visual communication by helping teams glean real-time information from diagrams with just a browser, turning data-linked diagrams into an operational dashboard that more employees can access. Visio Viewer for iOS brings high-fidelity viewing of real-world processes and plans to iPad and iPhone users. It includes a new exploration experience, which allows users to zoom into specific areas of a Visio diagram for a more detailed view. You can download the Visio Viewer for iPad today from products.office.com or from the iTunes Store. I've included links to these resources in the transcript to this course. To learn more about these strategic enhancements to Visio, check out the blog post, which includes some compelling use cases. If you're new to Visio, I encourage you to visit the Visio product support page in the link I've provided for a complete feature overview and a link to download Visio and take it for a test drive. Back in May of 2016, Microsoft released the Office Online Server, which enables organizations still running on-premises servers to provide their users with browser-based versions of Word, PowerPoint, Excel, and OneNote from their own data centers. On November 18th, the Office team announced the release of several significant updates to Office Online Server, including performance improvements to co-authoring in Word, as well as improved picture resizing within Word Online documents, improvements when working with tables in both Word Online and PowerPoint Online, support for showing spelling errors in line in the PowerPoint editor, as well as improvements to the copy and paste functions within PowerPoint Online, and support for embedded PowerView sheets in Excel Online. Admins for organizations using Microsoft's Office Online Server should visit the Volume Licensing Service Center to download the software. Moving forward, Microsoft will be releasing updates about every 4 months to continually deliver new value to Office Online Server customers. Just a quick note that Microsoft announced it has completed the acquisition of LinkedIn, the world's largest professional network. While some integration between Office 365 and LinkedIn's offerings already exist, there's more to come. Be one of the first to hear about these new capabilities by watching future updates. I'm Jim Naroski. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again next month.